Hello, brothers and sisters, and welcome once again to the In the News as we relate it to scriptures. This week, I would like to focus on the U.S. midterm election results. Looking at the board right here, America is divided states of America. The Senate is won by the Republicans, the House is won by the Democrats, and in both instances, they're almost split in the middle. So having said that, there are two things that I would like to focus on in connection to scriptures. First is on division. As I already have mentioned, we are split almost right in the middle. And when we say that, the words of the Lord Jesus Christ has been ringing in my mind when in the book of Matthew, chapter 12, verse 25, he says this, "Every kingdom divided against itself will be ruined, and every city or household divided against itself will not stand." You know, just hearing these words of the Lord, it just makes me wonder. Looking at the end time prophecies, and where is America at the end times? I don't see it. I don't read it. So I can just speculate of, you know, what could have probably have happened to America. But here's the point. The solution to the problems of the land is not on the government. It's not on the politicians. Look with me in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, 14. And this is a reminder to all of us who have put our faith in Jesus. And the Word of God says this, "If," that's a conditional word, "if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn away from their wicked ways, then," that's a conclusive word, "then I will hear from heaven and I will forgive their sin and will heal their land." So yes, brothers and sisters, it's true that it's important to elect and to vote for people whom we believe will be leading our country, your country, into things of God. But ultimately, solution to our land is in the hands of the believers, your hand and my hand, that if we seek His face, call His name, humble ourselves, pray, turn from our wicked ways, then He will heal our land. The second thing that came to my mind, considering this division that we do have in America, is on trust. Inasmuch as it is important to have, doing our responsibility to vote, to put the right people in place, I'm afraid that we Christians sometimes have been shifting our trust and putting our trust in other things, in other people, in our system, in a government, instead of putting our full trust in God. Jeremiah 17, verse 5 is a warning by the prophet Jeremiah. He says, "Cursed is the one who trusts in man, who draws strength from mere flesh, and whose heart turns away from the Lord." Who? Are we getting into that position where we are trusting things instead of trusting God? Psalms 20 verse 7 says, "Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we, the people of God, we trust in the name of the Lord our God." Now, I'm afraid that there's a lot of Christians today that have shifted their trust. Yes, by words they say, "I trust in God, I believe in God," but we have put more our trust in system, we have put more our trust in our money, we have put more our trust in our jobs, instead of putting our trust in God. So in conclusion, in these two things, on division and on trust, I think there's really just one main thing that the Lord is reminding us. Get back to God. Brothers and sisters, there's no more room for just half-heartedly serving our God. Give it all. trust in Him alone. So that's it for the In the News for this week. I trust that you are blessed with the Word of God. So go and trust Him alone.